So each believed the other to be some rare and costly trinket, and they began to converse together upon the world, saying how very conceited it was. "Yes," said the Darning Needle, "I have lived in a lady's box, and the young lady happened to be a cook. She had 5 fingers upon each of her hands, and anything more conceited and arrogant than those 5 fingers I never saw. And yet they were only there that they may take me out of the box and put me back again." "Were they of high descent?" asked the Bittlebottle. "Did they shine?" "No, indeed," replied the Darning Needle, "but they were none the less haughty. There were 5 brothers of them, all of the finger family, and they held themselves so proudly side by side, though they were of quite different heights. The outermost, Bumbling he was called, was short and thick-set. He generally stood out of the rank, a little in front of the others. He had only 1 joint in his back, and could only bow once. But he used to say that if he were cut off from a man, that man would be cut off from military service. Foreman, the second, put himself forward on all occasions, meddled with sweet and sour, pointed to the sun, and when the fingers wrote, it was he who pressed the pen. Middleman, the third of the brothers, could look over the others' heads and gave himself airs for that. Ringman, the fourth, went about with a gold belt about his waist. And little Playman, whom they called Peter Spellman, did nothing at all and was proud of that. I suppose there was nothing to be heard but boasting, and that is why I took myself away. And now we sit here together and shine," said the Bittlebottle. At that very moment, some water came rushing along the gutter, so that it was overflowed and carried the glass diamond along with it.